That's the end of a symphony. By Beethoven or Tchaikovsky. No matter which composer or how hallowed be his name, they all wrote good beginnings, but their endings sound the same. With banging on the kettle drums, those copper-colored metal drums. Between the cymbals crashing, the brasses keep rehashing the same darn note. The clarinets are tweeting and the tuba keeps repeating till it gets your goat. Then all of the musicians repeat these repetitions till you're ready for the booby hatch, and then they start again. The classical composer, be it Brahms or be it Bach, when it comes to writing endings, has an awful mental block. And that applies to Haydn and to Handel and to Glinka, to Rimsky and to Korsakov, and others I can't think of. The ending of a symphony is what they call the coda. And I've collected some of them. You ought to get a load of. They're actual and factual. I'll quote you note for note the endings of some symphonies that great composers wrote. A work of art should have an end that's not too short or long. To give you an example, here's a simple little song. Now let us take our simple song and find out if it blends well with the end of Schubert's seventh, and I hope all's well that ends well. The end of Schubert's seventh should be drastically diminished. He spent so long on this one that his eighth one was unfinished. You think the concert's over and you're halfway out the door, and boy, do you feel stupid when they start to play some more. When Schubert wrote this ending, he thought it was really super. Now he's come down through history as Franz the Party Pooper. I have an urgent message from the wife of the concertmaster. Your dinner's getting colder. Won't you play a little faster? Before this guy is finished with the trumpets and the horn, in this very concert hall, three babies will be born. The thing about this ending that makes us even madder, it's a test of the endurance of a music lover's bladder. Now let us put the end of Mozart's Overture to Figaro on Old MacDonald Had a Farm. It's just like adding Vigaro. On this farm, he had some goats. Mozart still got lots more notes. On this farm, he had a pig. Wolfgang, you wrote this too big. On this farm, he had a hen. Uh-oh, here they come again. On On this farm he had a horse. It had a better end, of course. One more time, Mozart, baby! And now let's take a simple tune, the well-known Yankee Doodle, and add to it Beethoven's Fifth, which makes symphonic strudel. Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It has been a pleasure to be... ...with you tonight. And I do want to thank the Boston Pops Orchestra under the direction of Arthur... ...Fiedler! ...for playing... for playing all of these magnificent melodies, including those of Ludwig von... Beethoven. Come on. Let's go. Oh, boy. They all were great composers, but what they didn't dig was how to write a simple ending like Little Porky Pig. That's all, folks. I want to thank all of you very much, and the Boston Pops and Mr. Fiedler for making this, I think, the most exciting night of my life. Thank you very much.